which is a presentation about the innovative ships, innovative ships for navigation in Arctic seas. In Arctic seas, it's a presentation of our university. We are from Maritime State University, named Admiral Nevelskoy, from Vladivostok, Russia. Sergei Agai, University President, and I am professor from University. And this presentation is on behalf of us too. The Professor Agai advised me to present this speech about the ships, innovative ships for navigation in Arctic seas. Okay, do you need the time to translate, or people maybe understand? People understand, I can keep talking.
他刚才就介绍了一下他们两个这个什么海事大学啊，另外一个从这个弗拉迪沃斯托克，就海洋，一个海事大学，是两个不同学校来的吧？是吧？
一个是校长，
一个教授是吧？
China is a great country of very good industry, and China is country of very good achievements in shipbuilding, in construction of ships. And the Russian Federation is of the interest to have the partnership with China in ship construction and in navigation, in the Arctic seas. So what is the innovative ships? What is it, innovative ships? The innovative ships, we say, is new classes of ships. New classes of ships which are prescribed by Russian government for Russian industry, prescribed by strategy to develop construction of these classes of ships. This is innovative ships. And besides of the innovative ships, in the world is are constructed ships of the mass construction, batch construction, like in China. China constructed a ship for merchant, for middle latitudes, for tropic latitudes. So, China has very good achievements in this area of industry. And Russia wants to have the partnership with China. And the first step, we need to develop our shipbuilding industry. Russia is a very good developed country in industrial aspect. But Russia do not have today very good developed merchant shipbuilding, because usually in Russian Federation ships are constructed for military, for navy, but not for merchant assignment. And the partnership with China could be, maybe people understand that. And in China, the partnership between Russia and China could be in the construction of merchant ships. Russian Federation on the first step want of Russians to develop a construction of ships for Arctic seas, because federal demand is a local demand for development of North Sea route and development of territories nearby the North Ocean. And it could be the subject for the partnership between Russia and China today. What is about, very brief. What is about strategy, Russian shipbuilding strategy? This strategy decided to construct a ship of new classes. First, we will tell about new classes. Which one? What classes? Russia need to have today, new ships. And the second is development of shipbuilding yards. Shipbuilding yards and construction of ships. So two main goals of the strategy of development of shipbuilding industry. And then maybe you know that in Russian Federation near Vladivostok today is almost ready new shipbuilding yard, a shipbuilding yard for construction of ships for Arctic. Ships for Arctic is north latitudes ships. A shipyard, we say shipyard Zvezda. Zvezda can translate from Russian to English like shipyard star. It is on the coast of the Gulf Peter the Great, very close to Vladivostok. And could please the next slide. Okay. And what ship required for Russian Federation? What classes of ship? Because it is interest on the first step to construct ships in parallel with countries of good developed shipbuilding in parallel with China, with Korea, with Japan, because not to have the competition. If not to have the competition, we would construct a ship of another assignment, not the same, then China construct, then Korea construct, then Japan construct. So Russian Federation is interested in the construction of ice navigation, tankers for liquefied natural gas, we say LNG carriers and the oil tankers. Those because Russian Federation will deliver cargo of liquefied natural gas from their north territories to other places, to China, to Europe, to East Europe, to West Europe. Second, Russia is interested in the construction of icebreakers. I will say in detail with the pictures in the next about icebreakers. Next, Russia requires to have a container ship for Arctic navigation. Maybe it is the container ship for North Ocean Road, like in a parallel to Silk Road. We told yesterday, but the parallel is the North Ocean Road. So container ship are required. Next is offshore platforms and equipment to work in Arctic offshore to mine the natural gas and oil from the offshore. Next is research ships assigned for Arctic navigation, scientific research ships. Next is the marine engineering facilities for power generation. And we in Russian Federation have some results in the construction of the facilities for power generation in the coast. Next, floating equipment for processing of natural gas, because natural gas to transport, we need to liquefy first. That is have to be the equipment, could be floating equipment. And you would please look at the slide and you can see all classes of ships are intended to use in the Arctic, in the north latitudes, in the frozen seas. And some characteristics of the federal demand is in the down part of slide. You can see that 90 specialized cargo ships total deadweight about 4 million ton we require. And ships for service and maintenance, about 140 units we need as well. And US breakers, we need as about from 10 to 12. And couple of the words about how much money Russia would like to spend, how much money. This whole program strategy of development of ships for Arctic Ocean could be estimated total amount money like equivalent of about $20 billion. Yes, it will be paid in rubles, yes, in dollars, but dollar equivalent about $20 billion. And of this 20 billion, of this 20 billion, like about 11 would be the financing on behalf of the government, and the rest part, government expected participation of the corporate investors together with the government, and together it will be like 20 billion equivalent for construction of ships. So private investors, private party would join as well to participate in their shipbuilding strategy for north latitudes. And could you please the next one slide? Thank you. Next, this is a collateral demand, not federal, but collateral. Some private company, like we have here, the joint stock company, we say Gazprom joint stock company for development of their natural gas and oil, and this company needs as well. It needs like 55 platforms drilling, and about approximately we have like equivalent of 43 almost billions United States dollars equivalent. This company needs 58 tankers, 46 icebreakers, 93 supply, and scientific ships as well. So this is just a very brief explaining of the biggest Russian company, yes. Maybe other companies do not need so many ships, but this one, yes. Could you please next one slide? And here on the slide, look please, and you can see the sample. Sample of ships required for federal government of Russian Federation. Today, before the completion of a new shipyard in Vladivostok, these ships could be constructed in the overseas. So Russia usually places it overseas in other countries, maybe in Korea, in Japan, maybe in China sometimes. Russia places orders annual each year of about equivalent $1 billion of United States dollars. And Russia constructed these classes of ships. You would please see on slide that all ships are of the ice class. So this is for Arctic navigation. The left one on picture one is a project of, we say, Project Yamal. This Project Yamal is for Arctic navigation, liquefied natural gas carrier. And this order had placed in the overseas. Usually these ships constructed in Korea. And the main engine, the power installation in the ship is Vertsela. This is very complex ship because it contains of great amount of cargo. The cargo amount is like 70,200 cubic meter of gas liquefied. And besides, the ship has the double engine power plant, very powerful. The capacity of the power plant total is 65,000 of kilowatt. The power plant is double fuel. One fuel is oil, another fuel is gas. So it's automatic power plant of two engines. And the ship is able to force ice. The ship can cross solid ice of thickness, like more than 2 meters thick ice, solid, the ship is able to cross, the left one. The right one is a concept, is interesting concept of ship of another, bit another class. Right one is, so we say DA class. DA class is the same assignment. Ship for transportation of liquefied natural gas. But it is interesting. The right one is mechanical, mechanics of ice forcing is that this ship on the right picture, it cross ice when it go stern. So it go front when in the open water and go stern in the ice. Because mechanically it is logical to cross the ice, go stern for crossing ice. It improves the property of ship to cross the ice. So this is the picture of the right one. About the same size, so like a 300 meter ship, 300 meter long, and about like up to 20,000 cubic meter, 20,000 cubic meter of capacity of the cargo holds. And please the next slide. Okay, as a sample of ships for Arctic navigation, as well, constructed in the overseas. So probably you remember, first we begin that Russia is doing today two ways. One way is construction of ships sometimes in the overseas, if it is in merchant ships. Military inside of Russia, yes. At the same time, Russia constructed today shipyards. And still, shipyards sometimes not completed, so the ships put in the overseas is a so-called Arctic navigation membrana gas carrier. Membrana gas carrier is a new way how to transport liquefied natural gas. We will show a bit in one of the next pictures about another way to transport liquefied natural gas. But this is the most modern approach. This is ships of length like 300 meter, and the beam of ship is 46. The right one picture is done last year. Right one picture is done last year in Korea. Korea Mokpo, very big shipyard. Deo Shipbuilding and Marine Engineering. So, DSME shipyard. We've been there, and Professor Agai and I was in there, and we make this picture of the right slide of the same class of ship. Please, next slide. On the left, you can see the concept of ship, of membrana LNG carrier, gas carrier for liquefied natural gas. It is a design of Russian design bureau in St. Petersburg. It is a Severnaya PKB, scientific design bureau. It is just three options. The same concept, but for ship of the cargo hold capacity, like for 80,000 cubic meter, 155,000 cubic meter, and 215 cubic meter. It is a picture on the left, the concept of LNG carrier. And on the right, you can see a ship in possession of Russian Federation. The right one picture, a ship Grand Aniva. As well, this is a liquefied natural gas carrier, I mean picture on the right. But you can see on the deck four capacities, like a ball-wise. And these capacities, even compare with the previous pictures, another way to transport liquefied natural gas. The left one is the more nowadays. The picture on the right, this boat, constructed in Japan. Japan, Russia put order in Mitsubishi heavy industries. And today Russia has three ships of this class. This one is Grand Aniva. Besides, Russia has Grand Elena and Grand Mireya. So this is three ships of this class in possession of Russian Federation today. Could you please next slide? Okay. Not only liquefied natural gas, cargo carrier Russia has today, is recently constructed for the last years, but as well Russia has oil crude cargo carriers like this on the picture, and these ships are intended as well in the North Ocean for Arctic navigation in the frozen seas. Left one is Captain Gotsky. Captain Gotsky is oil crude cargo carrier in possession of the left one is in possession of a Russian big shipping company, one of the biggest in the world, company owner of the Arctic navigation ships. Company is, we say, Sovcomflot. Sovcomflot we can translate like modern, nowadays, commercial fleet. And this company operates off ships like the left one for transportation of the oil in the frozen seas. And the right one is a picture of the sample of a bit smaller crude cargo just for transportation oil. As well, these two are not federal. This is private investors. They put orders for construction as well for North Ocean. For navigation in the north, in the Arctic seas. Please, next picture. And this table, we would like just to perform just to explain how many icebreakers any countries have in the world today. And you can see that Russian Federation today has in possession like 34 icebreakers total. And they constructed some icebreakers. And if you compare with other countries, Russian Federation today has icebreakers about the same, like all other countries taken together. Is a number of icebreakers, and many ships are under construction today. Besides, probably you know that maybe 1 month ago, maybe a couple, I don't remember. About 1.5 months ago, Russia in St. Petersburg launched a new... Russian Federation launched a new class of nuclear-powered icebreaker. It is not in operation, but it is already constructing the hull of ship, and maybe after a couple of years, this new icebreaker will be in the operation. So next, please. Oh, this is pictures of the new constructed nuclear-powered icebreaker in St. Petersburg. And I told about that it launched 1.5 months ago, about, in St. Petersburg, Russia. And maybe it will be, after a couple of years, in the operation. So this is a sample of icebreaker, nuclear-powered. And please, next slide. Not only nuclear-powered icebreakers, cooperation in Arctic seas, as well, under construction are, or constructed recently, diesel-electric icebreakers, which is more usual, diesel-electric icebreakers. The previous one, on the slide was icebreaker, the biggest in the world, the previous one. This is a bit smaller, but enough big icebreakers. You can see the on the figure 9 and figure 10. Figure 9, icebreaker of project 22,300. And the right one, the icebreaker of the design, like 22,600M. So it's about the same project of icebreaker, but another modification of the project. And maybe it is important just to underline that you can see on the picture that it's not a specialized icebreakers. All these two icebreakers, each of these two icebreakers, has on the deck the cargo. You can see containers on deck, containers and the cargo gears. So for today, usual is that the ships for Arctic navigation are not specialized. They are multifunctional. Sometimes they are icebreakers and the cargo ship simultaneously. And the next, please, picture. It is in more detail of icebreaker of project number 22,600M. You can see the cargo on the deck and you can see the deck gears. So this icebreaker can transport cargo and can appear cargo operations with the help of the deck gear and with the help of helicopter. So it is possible to use helicopter to process cargo operations as well. The next, please. It is samples of the icebreakers constructed recently. It is a bit some smaller than the previous icebreakers. The left one is icebreaker of the project 21,900, and the power of the main engines is 16,000 kilowatt or 16 megawatt as well. The right one, next smaller icebreaker of the design number 21,180. Next, please. Some more samples of icebreakers. On the left picture, you can see an icebreaker with not very usual shape of the hull, and you can see not symmetric shape of the hull. And on the right picture, you can see the icebreaker as well, a bit smaller size, but with not very usual propulsion. Propulsion is two devices in the bow and in the aft, is like we say azipod propulsion system. And they say small icebreakers can, on this picture before, can cross ice of thickness like about 1 meter. So what about thickness of ice? What maximal thickness? As nuclear powered icebreaker is able to cross solid ice on thickness. Is able to cross the thickness, ice of solid of thickness like 2.5 meters thick, and the biggest cargo ship, the on the first slide, is able to cross ice of thickness of 2.1 meter thick solid ice. And this is as well the sample of development of concept of icebreaker. It is like icebreaker, but at the same time cargo ship, which able to transport cargo on the deck. And it's possible to transport the oversized cargo. Its ship can be used in the construction of the offshore platforms for drilling, because it can transport the big aggregates of the platforms, oversized, on the deck. And this ship as well have very good ice properties, ice crossing properties. It can cross ice of thickness up to 1.7 meter thick of solid ice. Okay, please next slide. And this is a sample of, as well, Arctic navigation for North Ocean, North Latitude. A sample of a scientific research vessel. Scientific research, it is icebreaker, multifunctional icebreaker. Like all ships on the previous pictures. It is an innovative ship, ship prescribed as all we told before, ship prescribed by a federal strategy of development of shipbuilding industry in Russian Federation. This scientific research ship for North Latitudes, and it, ship, the ship is long, like 153 meters, and it is able to cross the ice of 1.1 meter thickness, more than 1 meter thickness of ice. Launch it in St. Petersburg. Next, please. This is an interesting subject of renovation of icebreakers, of multi-purpose icebreakers. You can see on the left Chinese ship. Chinese ship, as we can see long, I don't know how translate from China to Russia to English, maybe it is like polar dragon. Sulan. Snow Dragon, yeah. The ship is a sample of very good renovation of another one constructed in Soviet Union. The right one, you can see Vasily Golovnin ship, right one ship. You, Сергей Алексеевич, это бывший университет. This ship is multi-purpose icebreaker, and China bought this ship and processed the reconstruction of ship and did a new one, like Xulong ship, with very good ice characteristics for operation in the north latitudes and the frozen seas. The next, please. It is a sample of power, floating power facilities for generation of power. It is nuclear power generation facilities, Akademikon Lomonosov, we say. This ship launched maybe more than 1 year, I don't remember exactly when it launched. It probably in future, it will be in the operation. The assignment of this floating equipment is the generation of power in north latitudes for the coastal locations. Second assignment is the processing of the fresh water, so desalination of the ocean salted water, and to make a fresh water and to make a hot water. This is for operation for the coastal cities, coastal hub in the north coast of ocean. Next, please. And it is a sample which as well prescribed by Russian strategy of development of ship construction. On the left you can see the Arctic offshore platform. Arctic offshore platform, and on the right you can see the map in the North Ocean, and the red points on the right one picture are shown the places of mining of the natural gas. And if you would like to watch the right one picture, I mean the map, probably you can define that almost all the territories of the mining of the natural gas located on shore, not in the ocean. But some is in the some are in the ocean, some fields of gas. So on the first demand is the development of the marine engineering for transportation of the liquefied natural gas, as probably you even can take the gas on shore. But nevertheless, the second assignment is the mining of the gas in the ocean, because some fields are in the ocean as well. Next, please. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, conclusions of our presentation. The conclusions are, determining of prospect of shipbuilding and shipping for in Arctic and frozen seas development, what is the most important factors of demand? First of all, it's federal demand. It's characterized by two decisions of Russian government. There are exactly many decisions, but two of the most general decisions. One is the strategy of Russian Federation development of shipbuilding industry. It is almost about the development of ships for Arctic latitudes and frozen seas. The second, the general decision of the government is federal program, shipbuilding industry development for period of up to 2030 year is another second one. Which is in the more general state, the characteristics of demand for development of shipbuilding for Arctic and the development of shipbuilding in general. Two factors of demand we have. First is market demand, which is more maybe characteristic for China, China shipbuilding, because China usually oriented shipbuilding for construction for international demand of mass constructed ships of merchant assignment for transportation of all cargoes. And China has great achievements in this area of industry. And the second factor is the federal demand, or another local demand in Russian Federation is characteristic the demand of operation in Arctic Ocean and North latitudes. Please, next one. And shipbuilding industry development strategy and the appropriate federal programs can serve as an incentive for development of shipbuilding yards for a certain period. In the next are the options. One option is keep working in the interest of federal government after the decision of this federal government. And another way could be the transformation after the results of fulfillment of this federal strategy. The next way can be the transformation orientation of shipbuilding industry to the same way as China. So if we would have the facilities for construction of merchant ships, we would have the facilities as the result of fulfillment of Russian strategy oriented almost for north latitudes. Maybe these facilities are very usable in the next for construction of ships of other classes and the partnership in the next with China as well as a collateral way could be. The point four is what classes of ships? It is a repetition of one of slides before. What classes of ships we need? Yes, all classes of ships we need for development of Arctic navigation. LNG tankers, icebreakers, containers, and so on. Floating equipment, marine engineering. Some of these demands factors are very characteristic for Chinese shipbuilding as well today. And please, the next one. And for development of merchant shipbuilding and shipping, the international cooperation is of the great importance. First of all, the cooperation of those industries of the countries, very neighboring countries like China and Russian Federation. And the ways of their partnership could be for fleet replenishment, renovation of fleet, for operating of the marine cargo traffics, and for marine resources development. This could be the mutual goals of partnership with China and other countries, with China or Russian Federation. And in Arctic, it is very important the presumptions that Arctic has very good resource as an incentive for development of partnership in ship construction and shipping. And why it had the resources? Because of extent, because of the great industrial potential, and because the countries which can join the partnership, like China and the Russian Federation, these countries have very good experience in research and scientific research in the industry. And this all is especially for neighboring countries like China and the Russian Federation. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your attention.
那他还是高老师还得你简单的给我介绍一下，是我这个是讲一下他的东西还是讲的我的，先讲一下他的。他这个我想大家很多可能已经英语很好的已经听明白了，他主要还是讲这个俄罗斯联邦的这个就是下一个阶段对这些北极航行的破冰船呐、啊、或者是游船呐、啊、这个LNG 这些需求啊和建设还在建造的这些数量啊，包括这个海洋平台啊、油井啊，和以及这个建造这些船的这个所需要的经费，大概我看是说了大概是在190亿美元那样这样的一个数量，这是他联邦政府的这个情况。那其中也介绍了周边一些国家的情况，包括现代公司啊。 还有这个，其中也谈到了中国这个雪龙号，从这个从前苏联，我记得应该是从乌克兰是吧，买一条船改造的，主要是讲这个船舶方面，北极航行船舶方面的这个需求啊、建造啊和这个财政预算啊这样的情况。刚才也看到了这北极航行的在建造的那个已经有的和各个国家在建造的那个破冰船的和这个具有北极航行的这个船舶的这个。 数量是吧？俄罗斯还是远远的这个，远远的领先于其他国家。讲的内容应该就是这些。我这个听的是吧？是不是？看看其他还有很多英语好的同学、同志可以再补充一下是吧？
咱们就是针对，因为这个专业性太强了啊，我们搞文科的。
就是那什么，咱们希望咱们理工科的啊，或者对这方面感兴趣的老师积极的参与，谁有问题我们可以去提问呐、啊，或者这样的再发表一下。好，白院长。What's
the maximum ice thickness for the icebreaker cruise room?
It depends the ice thickness. Depends on the icebreaker, because it depends.
On the most advanced icebreaker.
Yes, it depends on the power, and depends on the displacement, and the length of the icebreaker. And for example, if a power is like 65,000 kilowatt, is like about 75,000 horsepower, 75,000 is maximal, and the length is like about 170 meter, and the power 65,000 kilowatt. So thickness today is 2.8. It's theoretical in the calculations. This nuclear powered icebreaker, 2.8, is solid ice. And if it's broken ice, just floating ice, pieces of the ice separate, it can be up to four. If it's solid, 2.8.
那就是稍等一下哈，就是你们刚才讨论的这个内容，能不能稍微的，哎，总总，哎，嗯，它说呢，就是说，基本上是和船的动力有关系，它可以达到这个两到八米，就是有的是两米，有的是八米这样，最高可以达到八米冰厚。那北极呢，一般四五六米最厚，它应该能通过。 And then that was, what's the cause difference between icebreakers and as glass ships or some other ships, what to think of?
Yes. And we can explain from behalf of classification society, or we can explain on behalf of theoretical concept. Classification society, I'm not expert in Chinese, but in Russian, classification society has the classification of graduation of ice categories. And there are some ice categories, and there are some, we say, Arctic categories. Ice categories and Arctic categories. And Professor Agai advised me that icebreaker's assignment is servicing of other ships, which have no ice category. And the ice class ship is not servicing of other ships, but it can navigate itself in ice without icebreaker. Yes, and sometimes it depends maybe on economics, because usually icebreakers has the excessive power of many engines. And from the economic point of view, it's not logical for transportation of cargo if a long way you have in the open water, not in the ice. So probably you would have icebreaker in location of ice, and you would use other cargo ships without ice categories, just usual, in the open water and in the ice with the help of icebreaker together.